see y'all with us this morning. One of my favorite things to do is to read the Psalms, and one of my favorite Psalms is Psalm 23, the Good Shepherd. I find something interesting, though, in John chapter 10, in which Jesus says, I am the Good Shepherd. From chapter 14, Jesus speaking, I am the Good Shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Just as the Father and I lay down my life for the sheep, I have other sheep that are not of this pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. You know, you think about the psalm, the Good Shepherd. It's a psalm of comfort. It's a psalm of encouragement. It's often given at funerals. It's not for the dead, it's for the living. And Jesus' words in John chapter 10 are for the living. It's for us. And the other sheep from another pen or another pasture, some translation says, is Gentile. He's referring to the Jews and the Gentiles, and that he died for both. By his choice, it wasn't something that was pressed upon him that he was overcome. It was something that he surrendered to. God the Father chose the time. God chose the place. And God chose the cross for each and every one of us. The songs that we read, that we sang earlier, if you realize, those songs are talking about our relationship with God. One-on-one relationship. Because God is a God of relationship. And he has a relationship with each one of us. And he paid the price for each one of us to have the hope of being with him in heaven, to have the peace that is provided by the sacrifice of his Son, Jesus Christ.